Hey, this is Jeff at Miller's RV, and I'm here to answer a common question we get. What's the difference between Class A, Class B, and Class C motorhomes? So we'll start out with Class A. Class A is a rail chassis, or the big motorhomes most people picture. The easy way to tell, if you look down the side of the motorhome here, you can see it's the same width from the front to the back. It's a fiberglass body built on top of a chassis. Now that can be a couple different options, and we'll show you another Class A in just a moment that's built a little bit differently. So this is again a Class A motorhome. It has, at the manufacturer, the chassis starts off with two rails that go down. An engine can either be in the front or the rear, so we have Class A gas or Class A diesel pusher, Class A motorhomes, both of them. So that is the Class A motorhome. Again, easy way to tell. Same length front to rear. It also does typically is the larger of the units. They'll go anywhere from as small down as, on some of them, 23, 24, 25 feet, but they go as large as 45 feet. So they are what most people consider, and most of them, most of the gas run 30 to 35 feet. Most of the diesels run 36 to 40. And then again, they do go over that as well. Okay, so one exception to the Class A, instead of starting with just two rails and an engine, Winnebago actually pioneered this category. It's still a Class A, but they pioneered this way of building a Class A with the Winnebago Via that I'm standing next to. We also see behind us a Thor Axis. They do it on a Ford chassis. The Winnebago Via was built on the Mercedes chassis. What they actually do is order the Class C cutaway chassis without the cab. So it comes in with the engine and the same running gear and everything else that a Class C would have, like a Winnebago View, but it doesn't have any of the metal. So it doesn't have the hood and doesn't have the cab, therefore they build a Class A on it. So it's a full fiberglass body, same width front to rear. So this is a Class A chassis built on the Class C, a Class A motorhome built on the Class C chassis produced by Mercedes. And the one behind us is again the Thor Axis, a Class A motorhome built on the same Ford E30 or E350 or E450 Class C chassis. Those obviously are going to be smaller units, but something a little different, kind of a cross between the A and the C. Still an A, but a very small A. Let's go look at the B's and C's. So we talked about the Class A, which can be the biggest of the motorhomes. This is a Class B, which can be the smallest of the motorhomes. But before you think that size is what determines Class B or C or A, it's not. The Class A built on the Via and the Axis is 23, 24 feet. This is a Class B motorhome, and what distinguishes it, if you look at it, it looks like a van. That's the difference. A Class B is built inside of an existing body provided by the chassis manufacturer. So we're in the Class A and the Class C. A chassis is provided by the chassis manufacturer, and then they build a motorhome body, either in the Class A, the whole body, or in a Class C, everything other than the metal cab where the drivers and passenger doors are. The Class B, it's the entire vehicle, exterior of the vehicle provided by the chassis manufacturer, with the exception of sometimes they extend a roof, but in this case of the Mercedes, they don't do that. It's this full chassis provided by Mercedes, and then they build the motorhome completely inside of it. So that is what usually typifies, or what does typify, a Class B, all in the manufacturer's body. Now, the Class Bs are typically gonna be the Mercedes, the Ford Traveler chassis, or the Dodge Ram ProMaster chassis are the three biggest ones. Historically, we had them built on the Ford, the old Airstream B vans was built on the Ford van chassis with a big mushroom top. Those were really popular way back in the day when I first started selling RVs, but now it's this Mercedes who owns the market right now. And again, the Ram ProMaster and the smaller Ford are also really good chassis options. Okay, finally we get to the Class C chassis. So the Class C chassis is a motorhome that starts off, the chassis comes from the van manufacturer with the cab area, and then a rail chassis or an open chassis behind it. Some used to call it a cutaway chassis because you take what would look like a van, it looks like it cut off the rest of the van. So it's just the driving area, the driver and passenger doors, the hood, the cab, the engine, and then the rest of the body is built by the body manufacturer, in this case, the one behind us, a Winnebago, and then we have back here a Chateau. So the body is, the fiberglass body is added on to an existing van body. Now, if you notice, The one back here is a Ford chassis, the one here is a Mercedes, and Chevrolet also makes some, not a whole bunch, but some of the Class C chassis. They're all Class C's because they all have a van body, van driving area, and then a body added on this fiberglass. So a quick caveat is, what is a B plus? A B plus is the same look. It's got a van front end, and technically a B plus really is a C, but what distinguishes it is, instead of having a cab that comes out and then goes up, which in this particular case on both of these, there's a bed area in it, the B plus goes from the windshield and slopes straight backwards. So it looks a little more aerodynamic, a little bit more like the all-in-one van body of a B, but technically it is still a C because it has a van driving area supplied by the chassis manufacturer, and then the rest of the body is supplied by the building manufacturer, RV manufacturer, however that might be. So again, that's your A, B, and C. Now let's look at benefits or differences between each of the three different classes. Okay, so now that we've seen all three types of units, I want to give you a couple differences between the different types so it may help you make a decision. Now, my first recommendation would be, don't let the type of RV be your primary characteristic. Instead, I would recommend let your floor plan, that the floor plan that fits your needs specifically, be the number one characteristic. I've done this for almost 28 years now, and what I've found over those years, if you don't get the right floor plan, you're not going to be satisfied with the coach. So find the right floor plan first, and then you can determine whether that floor plan specifically is in a Class A, Class B, or Class C, or if sometimes it's both. For example, the Winnebago 31, the Vista 31BE, and the Mini Winnie 31BE, same floor plan, just a Class A versus a Class C. Now, one of the benefits to the Class A is storage. So the Class A's, they do sit up higher, they're the rail chassis, so you're sitting up higher. The overall width is actually the same. A lot of people think the width of a Class A is wider than a C, but realistically, they're the same or within an inch or two of the Class A and C. The difference is you sit up higher and you actually sit a little further out, so it is a different feel when you're driving. So Class A's, you sit up higher, you have a really big windshield, so you do have this big, beautiful, Winnebago used to call it the Vista view, give you this big, beautiful view out the front windows that you get in a Class A motorhome. You sit high, everybody inside the unit can see out. Another big benefit is storage, and you'll see the storage compartments on a Class A, because it is built up on a rail chassis, it gives you more storage than what the Class C is able to do. Now, there is an exception. Some of the Class C back compartments, we'll show you one, is really big, but normally you're gonna get more storage in a Class A than a Class C. Now, when you go to a diesel pusher, so the Class A can be gas or diesel. The diesel pushers can be a straight rail chassis or what's called a raised rail chassis. That raised rail gives you that huge basement pass-through storage. So that would be the most storage in the industry, generally speaking, for the different type of unit. So storage is a big deal. And again, like I mentioned earlier, the size. If you want a unit that's 38, 39, 40 feet long, for the most part, you're going to be on a Class A or Class C Super C, which is something we don't see too many of, but on the big Freightliner chassis. Other than that, that's really your option. You're not going to get a B, and you're not going to get the standard C in that size. So again, let your floor plan be the first driver, and then look at some of the other features, including drive, which one you think, how the handling characteristics feel, and what do you think about it. So let's go look at one of the other models, show you some of the differences there, and then we'll wrap everything up. So we're back to the B. What are the benefits of the Class B? So typically, a Class B buyer is somebody who looks to travel a lot and wants the flexibility of not having a tow vehicle and being able to drive this wherever they want. A lot of our customers actually use this as a second vehicle. So a Class B, the Ram ProMaster chassis come as little as 18 feet. The Mercedes can come from a smaller one that the Roadtrek SS Agile used to be on the smaller 17, 18 foot vehicle up to about a 24 foot, which is the one we're standing here. And those chassis, that's the general length, is between 17 and 24 feet. Now, that basically means you can park in a regular parking space. So a full cab, eight foot bed truck is gonna be about the same length as this one behind me, maybe a hair smaller, but it's gonna be the size of the typical Class A. That, or Class B, that fits in a parking space, barely. It sure helps if you can have a parking space where you can back over the edge of the curb a little bit, but you normally can get around and park it wherever you want to. The other thing, obviously, is the width. These do not have, on the Class C's and the Class A's, they're wider than a regular passenger vehicle. This is the same width as a regular Mercedes van. So same width means it fits in the parking lots easier to get around. Obviously, drive-thrus are a problem. You can't go through a drive-thru, but you can pull into a restaurant, you can go downtown in a city, very easy to get around, very easy to maneuver, but you have the livability of a house. Now, most of the Class Bs have what's called a wet bath, meaning that the toilet and shower are all together in one area. There are a few floor plans. We have a Winnebago, one of their floor plans had a slide out and the rear bath is across the back. There's some other ones that have twin beds and rear bath across the back, and you have a dry bath, but most of the bathrooms in the Class Bs are a wet bath, and they're definitely smaller. So it's the trade-off of the easy drivability, easy to go places. It's also very much stealth camping because it doesn't look like an RV. So especially like in California, you can park this right up on the Pacific Ocean Highway where the Class A's and C's, they'll run you off. They won't in a B. So there is some stealth camping capabilities of this, but a lot of traveling is the general use for it, and the ability to carry people, but also camp two people. My wife and I have traveled a lot in this B since our kids have moved on to college. So it really has been really comfortable, and it gives us that bathroom, the bedroom, the kitchen space all together, but a vehicle we can drive around like a car. So that's the main benefits to the Class B. Storage, what I'd say probably the biggest limitation. Storage is definitely a premium on the Class Bs. Let's look at the C. Wait, before we go look at the benefits, will you do me a favor? Subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the reminder bell so that you can get the updates on all the chats, all the videos we're producing. You can see everything that's going on. Our goal here is to keep you entertained and informed. Let's go take a look at the benefits. Okay, so we're back at our Class C to talk about the benefits of that. I would say predominantly the biggest thing we hear about Class C's is that they're very drivable. That's the main comment we get for people who don't want to go as small as a Class B. They want more space, they need more storage, they have more people to travel with, but they don't feel comfortable driving a Class A. They go the Class C route. Now the Class C's are not necessarily, they used to kind of be targeted at the lower and entry level market. And that's still the case. We have our Winnebago Outlook, which is a great little unit that's designed for entry-level families. A lot of people that have come up from a trailer and want to try something bigger, have kids, they've got great bunkhouse models in them. And that's an option for a lot of people, is to step up into that. But that's not the only option. The one behind me, the Winnebago View, this is a 2021 Winnebago View, and it is one of the most luxurious classes out there. It's got beautiful countertops, high gloss imported cabinets, very, very nice unit, leather everywhere, seats swivel around, all the fancy features you would have in a high-end Mercedes chassis that's in a Class C. So it's not price, and it's not necessarily size, because they will typically run anywhere from as little as 19 feet, most of them start out now around 22, 23, to around 31, 32 feet. So the main difference again for the Class C is the cab area, and a lot of people feel really comfortable. So I mentioned in the Class A, you were sitting up and further out than you are in a Class C. In a Class C, you feel like you're driving a regular van, because you're in a regular van body. You sit where you normally would, so that means that everything on the road sits in the normal lane. When you're looking down the lane, it feels like a car, and that makes a lot of people really comfortable. Another benefit to it a lot of people have is it's a little bit lower profile, and again, compared to a Class A, it is a lower price, so it does give you the benefit of price. Exterior storage is not as much, except obviously in this case, when you see the video TJ's throwing in here, this shows you the exterior storage of one of the coaches that does not have a rear bedroom slide and gives us a huge outside storage. Most of the Class C's are not gonna have as much storage outside as the Class A's. Inside, the storage depends more on the size of the coach than on the type of coach. So a Class C 31 foot and a Class A 30 or 31 have about the same storage. Obviously, a Class C 31 is not gonna have the same storage as a Class A 36 or 37 or 38 foot coach. So that's the primary difference. Really, for you, again, I'll go back to the first thing I said on the benefits of the Class A. Find the floor plan that best fits your needs. And that's what we're here to do. We are not gonna, when you come here, we don't wanna just take you out and immediately start showing you units. We wanna find out, what are you gonna be using the RV for? How many people are gonna be traveling with you? How long do you wanna go? How much stuff are you gonna bring with you? Those are some questions that we're gonna ask so we can find out what you're gonna be using the RV for. Because just because your buddy Steve decided he needed a Class A, his needs and his use is different from what yours are, so you might be better in a C or a B. So each person is different, and we really wanna make sure that you get a coach that fits your specific needs, because again, as we always say, that helps you enjoy the journey. If you buy something because somebody else told you and it doesn't fit you, from my experience, you're not gonna be happy with the coach. And that's what ultimately we want. We want you enjoying your RV out on the road, sending us great pictures, and of course, wearing the Enjoy the Journey t-shirt. So If you have any questions about A, B, or C, give myself a call or one of our salespeople. We'll be glad to answer it. We'll be glad to talk through you the benefits and let you come out and see it and test drive. If you want to see what the difference in the drive between the A, B, and C are, let us know. We'll be able to handle that for you. Again, this is Jeff at Miller's RV. Enjoy the journey. Hey, thank you so much for watching our video. We hope that you found it both informative and entertaining. If you would, like this video and also subscribe to our channel so you can see everything new that's coming out as well. If you have any questions or comments, please list them below. Also tell us anything else you would like us to do a video on. Again, this is Jeff at Miller's RV. Enjoy the journey and click on one of the links to watch another video by us.